Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you having a Kia guys. It doesn't matter if you have a Kia Optima, Sorento, Sportage, Soul, Kia Forte guys, Kia Rio. We'll explain how to test purge control valves. Stay with us, we'll explain everything guys. Make sure to stay until the end. If you don't do something right, you can severely damage your valve. Even if it was good, it will be bad after that. So you have to follow certain procedure guys. Now, let me introduce you guys quick to the channel. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need guys in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep providing this free information for free. Something else, if you want to see videos about diagnostics, electronics, fixing electronic components, all that will be on our second channel, Electrical Car Repair Life. Check it out, we'll have quite helpful information. If you need to buy any parts or tools, anything for your Kia guys, we'll share the links in the description of the video below where we get all the tools and parts from for a really good price and quick shipping as well. So specifically guys, we have a 2013 Kia, but doesn't matter guys what Kia you have, if you have gasoline engine, you have purge control valve. Now you wonder what that valve does guys. Okay, it's pretty simple. Let's remove that hose a little bit so I can explain a little bit before we start testing guys. Okay, that valve will be installed, okay, usually between two hoses. One of the hose coming from the fuel tank brings the fuel vapors, and this is known as a canister hose. Even on your valve it may say canister. Then the one in the center, most of the times it's the one that goes to the intake manifold. And what it does, that valve, okay, when you have the gasoline in your gear guys, in the fuel tank, it's going to move around, and from heat especially it will start evaporating, and that gas back in the day used to be released in the atmosphere. But now, okay, what they did, they invented that purge valve, so that gasoline, okay, when you build enough pressure, the engine computer will activate that valve, and the vapors from the fuel guys, from the gasoline, will be injected in the intake manifold and burn through the engine. That way you're not losing fuel, you're not polluting and killing the atmosphere. So it's a win-win situation, more efficient car and cleaner air. But how you guys test those things? Okay, you may have so many symptoms, okay, so many codes for that purge valve. You have two wires guys, that's where things get interesting. It doesn't matter which one it is, positive or negative, you can practically reverse them and it still works. But if you have voltage applied and you touch these two together, you can say bye bye to your valve. So you have to be extremely careful. Alligator clips, okay, can reduce the chance for something bad to happen like that, but you still have to be careful. Now, if you want to see where to get alligator clips, parts, tools, check out guys the link in the description of the video below. We'll share all that with you for your convenience. So perfect, we have the two installed. If we get the car battery now going, okay, check it out now. Once you apply voltage, you'll hear a click and you'll feel it open. Let's reverse the wires, it will still work guys. Perfect, no problems at all. Now, something else guys. How we're going to test it? The fact that it's opening and closing doesn't mean much. Okay, it is working, but it may not be holding pressure, okay, or it may not be actually opening because it has seals on the inside. Get a balloon, okay, blow it up guys. Put it on the canister line that's coming from the fuel tank. Okay, get it tight so it's not leaking. Let's get it tight. Okay, that's what we're trying to do now, so it's not leaking. Perfect. Now, okay, almost there. Let's explain now. If you apply guys, if you apply voltage, that valve should open and you should release the pressure from the balloon. Check it out now. Let's come a little bit this way. Okay, do it now fast. And every time it opens, okay, you should let air out. When it closes, you should have no air coming out. So that's one good working valve guys. If you have problems with engine light being on, check your wiring harness, check, make sure you don't have a broken fuel vapor line somewhere, vacuum line, because that could trigger the light as well. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you next time.